guys, it's Bastion time. Welcome to Zelda News, I'm your host Bastion. Let's get straight to it. So basically, you've probably already seen a video that I did over on Zelda Dungeon. If not, be sure to check out Zelda Dungeon's YouTube channel. I do news there occasionally when there's breaking news. If you didn't already know that I was affiliated with them in some kind of way, now you do. But in any case, so Nintendo announced that they were going to have a Nintendo Direct and that it was going to be about Wii U games. Previously unannounced Wii U games. And this got me kind of excited because I finally thought, for once, they might have something to say about Zelda. Every time they've done a Wii U Direct, I keep hoping against hope that they'll announce something Zelda-alike, but knowing that it's probably not going to happen this time, I thought, pretty likely, probably. So I got up bright and early, it was at 6 a.m. my time, and watched it, and wowza, sure enough, not just one Zelda announcement, two Zelda announcements. And so basically what they announced is, yes, it's going to be taking them quite a while to do an HD Zelda, brand new, from scratch, for the Wii U, but that in the meantime, they've got something else to sort of tide us over. And that is, as a result of their experimenting with a lot of different visual styles from previous games. For instance, they experimented with an HD version of the Twilight Princess graphic style, and they used that for their Zelda experience for E3 last year, which was not to represent any particular kind of game, but just like what Zelda could be like using the game pad and that sort of thing. But they also, apparently in that process, decided to create a HD version of the Wind Waker's graphic style, and they liked it so much, they decided, well, why the heck not? Let's just go ahead and make this into HD Wind Waker. So to tide us over, we'll get to play HD Wind Waker. They didn't say too much about what exactly they're changing. They did say it's not just going to be HD graphics. It's, for instance, they're not just simply going to take Wind Waker's already existent graphics and then make them into 1080p resolution. They're actually going through and retexturizing all of those graphics, adding shades and really bringing them almost into like Pixar movie quality. And it just looks beautiful. But that's not even where this stops. They also said that they're going to be tuning the gameplay. So, what could that possibly mean? I mean, Wind Waker's gameplay is already pretty much perfect. But if they're going to be making this for the Wii U, they're going to be wanting to use the gamepad in some kind of way. And so, originally what I was thinking that they meant by this is that, you'll remember in the Wind Waker, there was the Tingle Tuner that you could find, and it allowed you to plug in your Game Boy Advance, and then have a friend use the Game Boy Advance to, like, drop bombs on enemies and things like that. So I thought, well, they'll use the gamepad for that, and maybe that means that they'll allow you to do Wind Waker in the one-to-one Motion Plus control style with your Wii Motion Plus controller and nunchuck. That would be pretty awesome, but I don't think that that's the case anymore, because one of the other things that they said was that you'll be able to play the game completely off TV, solely on the gamepad, so wouldn't really work out that way if that were the case. I mean, I suppose technically you could have the gamepad set up in front of you and then still use your Wii Motion Plus controller swiping around, but I don't see them doing that, so not really sure what they mean by fine-tuning the gameplay, so we'll just have to wait and see. But scrapping all of that silliness on my part, maybe you'll use your 3DS for the Tingle Tuner and connect in some way to the Wii U that way? I don't know. Now, I've seen a lot of people online sort of complaining about the fact that The Wind Waker is getting a remake, an HD remake, And they're just saying, well, Nintendo, just focus your attention on the new Zelda game that you're making for the Wii U. But that doesn't make any sense to me, because clearly Nintendo is having a completely separate team working on the Wind Waker HD thing. A team working on Wind Waker HD has zero effect on whatever Zelda Wii U turns out to be. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if, like, Griezo or somebody is working on Wind Waker HD. Somebody completely not even in Nintendo. So the fact that Wind Waker HD is happening doesn't mean anything at all with the time frame for Zelda Wii U coming out. So that's not an issue. And then also I've seen a lot of people say, well, you know, ugh, it doesn't look cel-shaded anymore, and that's not Wind Waker, and I don't want to play this. And to them, I just have to say, you still have your GameCube Wind Waker disc, right? Just play that. If you don't want to buy the HD Wind Waker, you don't have to. It's really that simple. I mean, this is kind of Bastion ranty right now, but something that kind of annoys the heck out of me is when there's a remake of something, people coming out of the woodworks and being like, meh, you're ruining the original. And it's like, no, the original still exists. You can still go enjoy the original. And if you want to, you can enjoy the remake as well. If you don't want to, you don't have to. You can just enjoy the original. So, when Ocarina of Time 3D was announced, and there were screenshots shown for that, there were people who were angry that it didn't look polygonal anymore. And that's just crazy to me, because, I mean, who wants polygons? But apparently a group of people do really want polygons, and didn't like the improved graphics for Ocarina of Time 3D. And I feel like these are probably the same people who don't like the improved graphics for Wind Waker HD, or maybe it's a different group of people, but in any case, I can't wait to get my hands on it. But in any case, as far as Zelda Wii U, they again had not much to say about it, except that it's going to be taking them a while yet. But they did say a few brief things. First of all, they are talking about going back to the basics, or rethinking some key aspects of what makes Zelda Zelda. And they mentioned two things. First of all, do dungeons need to be played in a certain order? And second of all, does Zelda need to be a single player experience? Now, I've got quite a few thoughts about this. Basically, I feel like I'm pretty sure they do not mean a four sword style game. I think that they just mean, like, if they do plan on using the Wii Motion Plus controller for all the sword play and stuff, maybe the multiplayer aspect will be that your friends can go ahead and join you on the gamepad and do a tingle tuner sort of thing. Like, you know, they'll use the gamepad in some kind of way. Like, the gamepad might have maps or something that you won't be able to see, but they'll be able to say, oh, you know, there's a secret thing over here, or something like that. I don't know. But as far as do dungeons need to be played in a certain order, that's pretty exciting, because, I mean, the original Legend of Zelda, you could defeat the dungeons in pretty much any order you wanted. In A Link to the Past, a little more constrained, but still, you could beat those in pretty much any order, and that still had a very robust story and such, so I'm pretty excited about that idea. I'm really interested to see what exactly they mean by this. As far as the graphic style, they were not forthcoming. They basically said, we're going to have to wait to see that. But my idea is, if they've already done the Wind Waker HD thing, they're going to want to do something completely different. So it might be a darker, grittier, Twilight Princess-y sort of style, maybe? Or maybe they'll do something along the lines of Skyward Sword. Who knows? We'll just have to wait and see. So that's it for this episode of Zelda News. Tomorrow is going to be some Nintendo news, also from Nintendo Direct, so stay tuned for that. See you then, guys. Bye.